Okay, good morning to my BS language class who's taking a foreign language this semester. So today is August 19 and it's the 146th birth anniversary of Manuel Luis Quezon. So I'm going to share my lecture today and hopefully you'd be able to craft a particular output individually this time in celebration of this month's celebration for national language. So I'm going to share my slides. Okay, I hope you are able to see the slide. And let's begin. So this is for both foreign language class for BAELS 3A and BAELS 3B for Japanese this semester. So as discussed during our online and in-person classes, we will focus on hiragana alphabet this first 8 to 9 weeks, and towards the end we will discuss the rules about the grammar, you know. So this is for foreign language that I based on my basic foreign language class in graduate school. Okay, so we will review about your practice writing sheets which you submitted during our in-person classes last Friday. And I'm also going to introduce the use of flashcards. So I'm going to provide you with the vocabulary and you're going to come up with your flashcards using 3x5 index cards. And I'm going to talk about the output for this activity. And I'm going to include the mechanics for Pecha Kucha presentation. And finally, I'm going to have an overview about the intangible cultural heritage inventory forms. So the reason for this is that you can prepare early for your attempt to be exempted in the midterms. So we will proceed. So as discussed during our first three meetings, so we would concern ourselves about Japanese reading and writing system. So there are four, you know. And firstly, it's about hiragana. So as you observed earlier and during our in-person class, so hiragana alphabet is made of curved lines and basically it's soft letters. So it's the phonetic representation of sounds and each letter corresponds to one mora. So one mora is a unit of sound. So including vowel sounds, a, e, u, e, and o. So this is used to write particles, conjunctions, or interjections. So including the consonant sounds, ka, sa, ta, na, ha, ma, ya, ra, wa, and ng sound. So that makes the 5 vowel sounds and the 10 consonant sounds. So for goju-on. Okay, so let's continue with katakana. So this is going to be our concern after the midterms from week 10 to week 18. So if hiragana letters is composed of hard letters, it's made of straight lines. Katakana is used for foreign language in the perspective of the Japanese, or words like names of persons, cities, and countries to become Japanized. Phonetic representation of sounds is like hiragana, and one letter sound corresponds to one mora. So mora is a unit of sound. So if there is goju-on in hiragana, there's also goju-on in katakana. So the sound of 50 in hiragana is the same sound of 50 in katakana. So the difference is the representation of these sounds. So in addition, there is kanji. So we will not discuss this in great detail, but we will pass by and emphasize some of the key ideas about kanji. So these are letters introduced from China, which is used for writing sounds and stems of verbs and adjectives. Express not only sound but also meaning through pictures like rice field or river and mountain. I think the example that I gave you during the in-person class is river or kawa. So we can continue this during our succeeding lessons. And lastly, this is how we started, and I hope you're continuing with your practice. And so the last time we had during the in-person classes is writing your Japanese names. So we are using Romanji. So these are Roman characters that have been recently used for names of stations and for advertising words. It is intended for foreign visitors of Japan, but these are rarely used in regular sentences of Japanese except as symbols or marks, like the sentence pattern we discussed. No? So the greetings, Ohayo gozaimasu, or konnichiwa, and even konbawa gozaimasu. And your self-introduction. So your name, this case mine, is Randy Noboresades. So greetings, then your name, Japanese sounding name, and the pattern des. Okay, so Ohayo gozaimasu, Randy Noboresades. So you could also replace Randy Noboresa with Watashi. So Watashi wa Randy Noboresa des. Okay, so moving on. So I talk about this during our in-person meeting, so we will just continue. So I explained there are levels and layers of meaning, especially regarding the hierarchy in Japanese society. So there's a polite gesture for our boss and our superiors, and there is also a gesture for our friends or our peers and colleagues. Okay, so the first thing that we do in class, it's important that we start with discipline. So kiritsu or stand up. So you can use this as your vocabulary, but you just write it down and we will continue. So next is Ohayo gozaimasu, or good morning. So we already mentioned this. And the next greeting is konnichiwa, good afternoon. This could also be used as good day. And konbawa, good evening. So I explained the changes in the pronunciation, and there's a silent N and the change in M sound, like in kampai and gambate. Okay, so next is onegaishimasu, or please. So this is in conjunction with a verb. And the reply to thank you is you're welcome, dou itashimashite. Okay, so some more greetings. So dou itashimashite is the polite way of saying the response to this is arigato gozaimasu, or thank you very much. You could also make use of domo arigato. So this is the more polite way of saying thank you. Or in the past, so if the paper has been given, so arigato gozaimashita. So this I explained earlier during our in-person class, wakarimasu ka, or do you understand? So the affirmative way of responding is hai, wakarimasu, or yes, I do. And the negative on the other hand is ie wakarimasen, or I don't understand. So next is, this is the way that you're going to ask permission if you want to go out. Sumimasen, excuse me, or I'm sorry. But the more polite way of saying this is shitsureishimasu. So it's a bit mouthful, but you can do it in due time. So if we started with tiritsu or stand up, so we end with chakaseki or sit down. We stand up and we sit down in class. Okay, for the vocabulary, I'm going to just walk through this. So this corresponds to your practice writing sheets, and this is what you're going to do in your flashcards in the 3x5 index card. So you write on one side the romanji, including the meaning, and on the other side is the Japanese character, the hiragana character ah. So the vocabulary entry this for this is I or love. So next is e. So it's like a long vowel sound, e. So it's not the same as the negative e. E. Or this is the one character only, e. So it corresponds to the meaning painting. So ue, this time is on top. And au is for the color blue. So next is, as you know, earlier for the response, ie means no. So this time we're moving with the consonant sounds, ka in the karo, so ika or squid. So what you're going to do in your flashcards, you're going to draw the figure that best represents this vocabulary words. So aki is for autumn, the season. Koi is for boys. Eki is for station. Aka is the color red. Kau is face. Meanwhile, kikai is for machines, not what you're thinking. Sake, you should be familiar with this. It's Japanese wine. So there are some more vocabulary. So for tomorrow, it's ashita. Okay, so we are going to continue with the slides. I'm just going to share this with you. So for the instruction of for today's activity. So since we are celebrating not only the 146th birth anniversary of the father of Filipino language, Manuel Luis Quezon, we're also having an activity at the National Museum called Art of Poetry. So it's a poetry writing workshop for high school students or selected students from secondary education. So the theme for this this year's celebration is Filipino Wikang Mapagpalaya. So to show the significance and value of our national language. So if we are studying Japanese as foreign language, so we should also pay attention to our own language. So on the other hand, so it's also History Month. So the theme for this year is Salaysay ng Bayan, Saysay ng Bansa. So the design element that the National Historical Commission of the Philippines decided to make use of your signage in the jeepney. So if you're going to find or locate where is Marinduque, so it's in the right hand side. So you just look for Marinduque and you will find where it is located. And finally, so by next week, don't get excited with the super long weekend on the 26th and on the 23rd. So there are some more instructions in store for you. So like say for the, not only for the flashcards. So since the activity in National Museum is about art of poetry, there's also a format or a form of short poems in Japanese. So there are haiku and also tanka in a more modern form called haibun. So I'm going to detail this instruction, but you could always search in the internet for examples. So I think that would be all for this session. So I'm going to keep updated in the Google Classroom, and also we put up public social media community for you to join in. So I'm going to ask you to not only submit in the Google Classroom, but also post your Japanese poems in appreciation of not only the foreign language, but this time in Filipino. So thank you and good morning again.